Hi there, my name is Zoran Horvat. In this video, we will continue the discussion of entity framework migrations, creating them, editing them, so to never cause a downtime when applying them to production. We have already been talking about zero downtime application of entity framework migrations. In the previous video, you could see how to apply migrations to add a new column to the production database without stopping the application that already works in production. And today we will remove a column. There will be modifications to the process, but it is possible again to create a migration and to apply it to the production database without stopping the working application. It is all about the order of steps when applying a modification to the database schema and a modification to application code. The database change must be designed in such a way that the old application doesn't break. And then when the database update is over, you can install the new version of the application, start pointing users to that version, eventually turn off the old application version, and the update is over. There is already a video on zero downtime deployment, so if you have any second thoughts about that topic, please watch that video. Here is the link. And now we can start with the new request for this video. This is the only model we have in the application, the person with two columns, full name and birth year. We are continuing the development of this application, and the request is to remove the birth year. For some reason, this column is not required anymore, and we want to just delete it. There are some historical data, and the existing, which is the old application version, is actively using them. The idea behind zero downtime updates is that you change the database schema in such a way that it becomes more general than it was, so that both the old and the new application can still work with the same database schema. But the new application will use the added features of the schema, the features the old application doesn't know about. Once the application code is also upgraded, there will be no old application anymore, then you can remove the leftovers from the database schema, and then both the schema and the code will assume their final versions that have no trace of the old part, in this case the old column that we wanted to remove. The question is, how do we make the database schema more general as a preparation for removal of a column? One way is to make that column obsolete, to turn it nullable in the model, so that we can start ignoring it. The database will populate null in place of missing data, and everybody should be happy. In the application, start ignoring the old column. Don't ask for it when creating a new object. Compiler will not complain because the field is set to null initially. Remove every trace of birth year in the UI. Remove it from the post action, there will be no birth year posted. Search for other references to the property we are ignoring. Now comes the interesting part, the migration. Update the database. And here is the alter table, nullable birth year, just as we wanted it. Everything is the same from the database point of view, only the column is nullable, but the old application doesn't know about that. It will keep using that column as if it were mandatory. But again, the old application is already using that column in all places, so there will be no trouble with that. The new application is ignoring this column, and that is where nullability comes into place, because the database will fill in now, whenever we just skip setting the value. The first step is over. If you liked this video so far and want to help me spread the word about it and make other users at YouTube find it, please press the like button right now, because what follows from this point on, you're not going to like that. Let me show you. We are ready to make the breaking change, to remove the property. That is what we wanted from the very beginning, so we can remove the property, but we must be careful with migrations. Let me create the migration and you will see there's the warning of data loss. Entity framework wants to drop the column, but the old application is still running and it is still using that column. So we must not drop the column effectively in the database, because we must support both versions of the application at the same time. So what I will do is to comment out the drop column call and just leave the column in the database. I will remove it from the application. It is entirely gone in the application, both in the model and in the UI. And I want to retain the old data in the database. That will let the existing old version of the application keep running as it does right now. That will let you advance the deployment pipeline by only changing the model inside the application, but leaving the database effectively intact. I will apply the migration and both applications should work now. Take a look. While updating the database, the old application is still running. I'm using it. It is actively using the old column, and it didn't lose the information either. Let's update the application now. Here it is. It knows nothing about the birth year. And if I added a person, that should work too. Yes, the new record is here, there's no exception, nothing broke. And here is the explanation. The new application is really not using the old column. Database leaves it null. The column is nullable, and so the last record here really has null value because the new application ignored the column. And the log will unveil the mystery, inserting only the full name. This is the log from the new application, selecting only the full name. And that is the time when it tear down the old application version. So the situation is that now we have a new schema in the database with nullable column and a new application, no old version anymore. The new application, which is ignoring the column, it has no knowledge of that column's existence. When I commented out that drop column call in the migration in code, I have effectively stopped tracking the column in the entity framework. Entity framework doesn't know that this column exists anymore. This is the ghost column. And it could stay there for quite a long time. I have seen such ghost columns remaining in the database, in production databases, for years, because customers are afraid that the day could come when they just changed their mind and wanted the old data back again. Of course, they can keep the old data in a backup, they can store it somewhere else, and eventually they might decide to drop the database column after all. You would just include an alter table statement in some later release that will not affect the application at all, that will not affect the database either, and just drop the column as part of the future update. Here, the table without a birth year column, just as we wanted it. So this completes the process of removing a column from the database without ever having to stop the application while you are deploying the new database schema or the new application code. It is the process of removing a database column with zero downtime. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, and see you in the next episode.